Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel, guys. In today's video, guys, we'll be working on Chevy Cruze and we're going to explain the most common reason, guys, for airbag light to be on. Stay with us and we'll explain what it is, guys. This is the most common reason that you can have, guys. Now, there is a second reason that is still common, but not as often as this one, and we'll explain what that one is, so make sure you stay until the end. Quick introduction, guys, we will have more than 200 videos on this car and every car we get at the shop, because our mission is to save you guys as much money as we can. So please subscribe to the channel and like the video. Hopefully, guys, you will find the video helpful. So let's go ahead, start on it. All the tools and parts, including the scanner that we'll be using, all that will be shared in the description of the video below for your convenience. Let's start on the problem now. So I'll go ahead, start the car, and I'll show you how the airbag light is on. Okay, let me show you now. We're going to connect the scanner in a second. So if I start the car, you will know this airbag light just stays on, guys. Okay, no matter what you do, okay, it stays on. And it probably will tell us on the screen that we have a problem with the airbag in a second. Okay, let me switch here. Service airbag, guys. Okay, what can cause that now, guys? Let me turn the car off and I will explain. We'll turn ignition on. So let me show you what scanner we'll be using. We'll be using, guys, Maxicom by Autel. Okay, let me clean the screen a little bit. This amazing scanner, I'm going to plug it to the OBD port of the car. Okay, this end, you just connect it to the OBD connection down there. Okay, check it out, like that. Now, we're going to, guys, select diagnostics here. We have the ignition key on. Check it out, ignition key is on. Now, that computer is amazing. Check out the link, it will be in the description of the video below. You can do so many things with that. You can read and delete codes from every computer in your car, and it supports so many different makes, guys. So that thing can pay itself off in just a couple of times, okay, instead of going to the dealer for diagnostics or resetting your airbag, engine light, whatever it is. So we're going to select to manual selection. We're going to select 2015 passenger car Chevy Cruze, and it asks us which engine. 1.8. Now it's going to load. It will take just a little bit of time for it to load everything. We have a different type of radio system, diagnostics, control unit, and here, guys, we are going to select inflatable restraint sensing and diagnostic module right there. And the codes right here, we click trouble codes and we are going to get the code, guys. This is the most common one that you will see, U0170, guys. It says lost communication with passenger presence module. What that means, okay, you know that the airbag systems in modern vehicles are complicated things. It detects how heavy the person is here, so it knows whether it should activate the airbag on or off. Why? Because if you have a smaller person, the airbag can kill them, so it adjusts it according to the weight. So this, guys, is a problem with the sensor that detects that. We have a video on the channel that explains how to fix it, and I'll show you where it's located now in a second. If you need to replace it, we have the video, but sometimes it's just a loose connection. I'm going to turn the ignition off. Every time, guys, you mess with airbag systems, what I recommend, disconnect your car battery at least 1 hour before the repair. And if you're not certified and qualified to do the repair, don't do it, guys, because those little devices can kill you and your passengers. So consider this entertaining video another how-to video, but we'll show you what to look for and what we usually do and if that is going to fix our problem now. So if you guys go back, okay, I want to show you something. If you go to live data before we start working on it, okay, I'm sitting in the passenger seat now, not the driver's seat, I'm in the passenger seat. And here, guys, you have a few different things that you can see, okay? Primary key, security, sensing and diagnostic module. You have so many things that you can check with that computer. It's just pretty much amazing, guys. But under one of those screens, okay, you will be able to see if that seat is actually working or not. And I'll show you, okay, how to do that in just a second. This is for the deployment status here. No, we don't need this thing. So give me just a second and we should be able to find it here quick. enabled, enabled, disabled. You have so many things, guys. It's just amazing how much information you can get with that scanner. Okay, driver seat belt right here will be passenger seat belt, passenger seat position sensor enable status. Ours says disabled, so it means that there is, it doesn't detect a person. No matter what I do, if I see it, it says that there is no person. So you can see, guys, it should say enabled. So what we'll do, we'll turn ignition off. We're going to go ahead, guys, disconnect the car battery, and we'll continue one hour after that. So if you come under the seat now, guys, right here, this is the sensor. Okay, right there, this is the one that detects. So usually I pull that red thing back, push here and disconnect it. Okay, and this is, guys, okay, this is the wire. So reconnect it, check it, make sure that it didn't get loose somewhere, because sometimes if you put something under the seat, you may knock it loose. This thing here, this is for the seat belt. Okay, that yellow one is for the seat belt, so make sure that it's connected as well. And we'll go ahead, okay, and replace ours. We'll have the video on the channel and see if that will take care of the problem now, guys. So we connected car battery, everything's ready to go. I'm going to go inside now. Okay, turn ignition on again. Okay, I reconnected the scanner already, everything should be ready to go. So let's go ahead and see now. Okay, I'm going to see if it's establishing communication. Perfect. Okay, the one that says passenger indicator. Okay, passenger seat position sensor enable. Status disabled. Let's go ahead and sit on it now. Okay, let's sit in the seat. Okay, and give it some time. Okay, and you can see seatbelt reminder flashing. Passenger airbag status changed to enabled, guys. Okay, now let's get up. It says enabled, disabled. Let's sit back. So that's what we're looking for, passenger airbag status. We're sitting in the seat now, and the thing will change to enabled. So you can see, guys, this is definitely working. And it says passenger classification, occupant type 6. Okay, so let's just lift up just a little bit, not much, just a little bit. And it might change to unidentified. Let's put down a little bit more. 6. Okay, so it tells us occupied right here and occupant type 6. So that, I think, will be dependent on the weight as well. So you can see passenger present sensor seat occupant status occupied, enabled airbag, and the occupant type size. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful. We'll show you how to fix that. Thank you for watching, guys. Please subscribe to the channel and see you guys next time.